Okay, we'll start. It's time. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. كيف حالكم صف ثاني؟
السلام عليكم.
بخير شكرا. السلام عليكم.
أحسنتم. أحسنتم وعليكم السلام. صباح الخير.
صباح الخير.
صباح النور. Okay, we'll start now, my students. As usual, I will put you all your mics mute. You will listen to me carefully. Okay? Not to disturb each other, please. Keep your mics mute unless I ask you and you want to answer. So, at the beginning, I want to remind you about the marking attendance. Don't forget to do it now or by the end of the session. Okay? And last week, some of you, few students, couldn't see the PowerPoint that I shared. For this week, inshallah, we'll not have this issue because I, just 2 minutes before starting, I uploaded the file, I mean the PowerPoint, on the team. Okay, you will find it just after the scheduled meeting. You will find the PowerPoint of today, the lesson of today, uploaded there already. So you can open it from there and follow with me. I will remind you every time with a number of slides, or you can follow with the, with the camera that I where I shared the PowerPoint of today. Okay. Hope you all can see this. And at the same time, I'm recording the lesson. You will find it recorded also on my learning. Okay, so no one, inshallah, will tell Miss, I cannot see the lesson. You will find it in different files. Okay, we'll start. Today also our lesson, Al-Amakin fi Dubai. Al-Amakin fi Dubai. We are carrying with the same lesson, but new places. This time we have new places. So for those who are following with me from their PowerPoints, I am now in the first slide. The first slide, just the title. Al-Amakin fi Al-Imarat. Places in the UAE. I want you to have your notebooks or your papers just next to you because we are will try to write your sentence also if you want to write them down, if you want to share them later. You can also let mom or dad take pictures for you or videos while we are doing this live session. Okay, and you can send it to me later. So we'll move now to the second slide. Second slide where we find the learning objectives. اليوم سوف نتعلم أماكن جديدة. اليوم سوف نتعلم أماكن جديدة. We are going to learn new places. وسوف نصف الأماكن. And we will describe the places using also صفات جديدة. New adjectives. Today we learn new adjectives also. I'll move now my students to slide number 3. Okay, hope you follow with me. Slide number 3 is the most important one. Here you have the new places. الأماكن في دبي. ننظر إلى الصورة. ننظر إلى الصورة. ثلاث أماكن. عندي ثلاث أماكن اليوم. الصورة الأولى. الصورة الحمراء. الصورة لونها الأحمر. ما هذا المكان؟ ما هذا؟ ماذا نشاهد في الصورة؟ نفكر. الصورة الأولى هي السينما. نستمع. الصورة الأولى السينما. السينما. سوف نكتب. أحسنتم. سوف نكتب السينما. سوف نكتب. أنا أيضا اليوم سوف أكتب معكم. سوف نكتب السينما. It's a new word since it's similar to the one to the English word. Okay. يلا نكتب السينما. نكتب ألف ألف لام
سا يا نا ما ألف.
أحسنت. نكتب ولا نشاهد الكلمة. يلا بسرعة. سوف نكتب ولا نشاهد الكلمة. ألف لام سين يا السي ني نون ميم ألف. السينما السينما السينما. أحسنتم. السينما أين نشاهد السينما؟ السينما في دبي. السينما في متجر ابن بطوطة. أنا أذهب
إلى السينما.
ممتاز. أحسنت. أحسنت محمد ريان. أنا أذهب إلى السينما. ممتاز. أنا أذهب إلى السينما. I can also extend my sentence, Rayan and the other friends. I can make it longer. For example, I can say, أنا أذهب إلى السينما في متجر ابن بطوطة. أنا أذهب إلى السينما في متجر الإمارات. I can also say, أنا أذهب إلى السينما يوم الجمعة. يوم الجمعة. ما معنى يوم الجمعة؟ الجمعة.
يوم الجمعة. Friday.
Friday. So you can also add a day. Friday. You remember the days? I will sing. Please keep your mics mute and let's just sing the song of the days, just to remember the days of the week that you can use in your sentence. You will repeat with me, but keep your mics mute, my dear friends. سبعة سبعة هي سبعة أيام الأسبوع سبعة 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 هي سبعة أيام الأسبوع سبعة السبت الأحد والاثنين السبت الأحد والاثنين الثلاثاء today الثلاثاء الثلاثاء الأربعاء الخميس والجمعة سبعة سبعة هي سبعة أيام الأسبوع سبعة 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 هي سبعة أيام الأسبوع سبعة. Okay, hope that you now remember all the days. So we have السبت Saturday, الأحد Sunday, الاثنين Monday, الثلاثاء اليوم الثلاثاء today is Tuesday, tomorrow غدا الأربعاء الأربعاء والخميس والجمعة. نعم.
How do you say on in Arabic?
On we don't say it in Arabic, we just say يوم الجمعة. أنا أذهب إلى السينما يوم الجمعة. Just at the day. يوم الجمعة. أحسنت محمد ريان. Good question. And now we'll move my students to the second picture. الصورة الثانية. الصورة الثانية. It's written there in English. We want to find it in Arabic. Cafe. How to say it? This is a new word. It's actually المقهى. أحسنتم. المقهى. لنكتب المقهى. Let's Let's write it. Who will do it fast? Al, Alif, Lam, Mim, Qaf. Two dots up for Qaf. Al-maq, ha. I have ha, and at the end, I don't have ya, but I have what I call alif maqsura. It looks like ya, but without dots. Because if it was ya, I have to say al-maqhi. But here, there are no dots, it's not ya, so it's same as long alif. Okay? Al-maq, ha. Okay, long vowel for the fatha. Al maqha. Write it, please. I will raise my paper. Are you done? Al maqha. Al maqha. Hope you wrote it all correct. Ahsantum. Al maqha. نفكر الآن في جمل عن المقهى.
المقهى من شوب؟
لا، ننظر إلى السورة. المقهى كافي.
المقهى is restaurant.
المطعم restaurant. المقهى is only when we drink coffee, juice. It's cafe. It looks like al-mat'am, but it's only for drinks. So we call it al-maqha. Okay? You know this word comes, it's similar to the word coffee itself. The word coffee in Arabic is qahwa. Ana ashrab al-qahwa. I will write it for you. Ana ashrab al-qahwa. Alif lam, qaf, ha, wa. And ta marbuta. Al-qahwa means coffee. Al-qahwa. Al-qahwa. You can see it? So, you can use this word to make a sentence about al-maqha. Ana. All of you follow with me, please. Ana. Ashrab. القهوة أين؟ أين أشرب القهوة؟ في المقهى. في المقهى. Who said cafe in English? I want you to say it in Arabic. المقهى. أنا أشرب القهوة والعصير. أنا أشرب العصير. نعم.
Please repeat it again.
Okay, my dear Abdullah. أنا أشرب القهوة. القهوة. أنا أشرب القهوة أين؟ في المقهى. المقهى is the word that you see on the slide in front of you is the cafe. أنا أشرب القهوة في المقهى. Okay? You can use something else instead of القهوة. ماذا نشرب أيضا؟ أنا أشرب العصير. أنا أشرب العصير في المقهى. Or how to say I sit in the cafe. نعم تكلم. نعم
أجلس.
أحسنت. أنا أجلس. ممتاز. أنا أجلس في المقهى. نعم. Up. ارفعي صوتك. I cannot hear you. Please say it up.
Atlas, sea, el cinema, cinema, el ab, sea, el
Anna, أشرب القهوة.
Ryan, just 1 minute, please. Let your friend finish her sentence. I'll come back to you. So the first sentence was أنا أجلس في السينما بينما الأب يجلس في يجلس في المقهى. I want you to use the day of today. I mean the word of today. المقهى. أحسنتي. جملة رائعة. ممتازة. جملة رائعة. I clap for you. جملة رائعة. It's a very long sentence. أنا أجلس
معلمة.
في السينما. I'll come to you, Ryan. Just 1 minute. I want to explain the sentence of your friend to the rest of the friends, okay? I'll come to you just after I finish, Ryan. Just 1 second. So, أنا أجلس في المقهى. أنا أجلس في السينما بينما أبي يجلس في المقهى. Very good. Two sentences you are using here, combined by بينما. بينما means while, okay? I sit on the cinema, in the cinema while dad sits in the cafe. نعم, Ryan, you can say now your sentence. ممتاز. أحسنت. أنا المقهى في دبي. المقهى في دبي وأنا أشرب القهوة في المقهى. ممتاز. أحسنتم. نعم. أنا أستمع. نعم.
أنا عندي جملة.
تفضل. نعم. قل. You can say.
Daddy.
Please, while your friend is saying his sentence, the others mute your mics, please. Okay, see, I will mute you all. Sorry, I muted you all. Only your friend who will say his sentence, he will open his mic now, please. Naam, was it Ryan or...
سباندانا.
نعم. تكلمي سباندانا.
أمي أجلس في السينما وأنا أكل في المدرسة بينما أبي أجلس أبي أجلس في الكرسي.
أبي يجلس على الكرسي. على الكرسي. Okay, Spandana, and the other, please pay attention. Spandana here, her sentence is very, very nice. It's a very long sentence, but just she has one mistake when using the verb. She said, أمي أجلس. In the end, she said, أبي أجلس. Pay attention how to use the verb. أبي يجلس. أمي. She's a girl. أمي.
تجلس.
So let's repeat from the beginning how to use the verb with the pronouns. The verb يجلس. أنا
أجلس.
هو if he's a boy. هو يجلس. هي تجلس. ونحن نحن all of us نحن نجلس. أحسنتم. We'll come to it in the next slide, but before going, now my إذن sorry I muted you all because now we need to move to the third picture and the third word of today, the third place of today. You can look at the third picture on your slide, please. المستشفى. It's a long word. Repeat with me. المستشفى. المستشفى. لنكتب المستشفى. Let's write it. Let's write المستشفى. ألف. All of you write it on your notebooks. يلا. ألف. لام. ميم. المو. المو. ميم. س. سين. المس. المس. ميم. س. تا. المس. تا. تا. Don't be confused. Two dots up. المستش. شا. Now. شا. Sheen is the same like seen, but with three dots up. المستش. شا. And فا. 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 فا is same like قا. قا that we wrote in مقهى, but with one dot only. المستشفى. And at the end, I have that alif, that long vowel without dots. Again, I'm telling you, it looks like yeah, but without dots. المستشفى. المستشفى.
معلمة.
نعم. نعم. نعم.
How do you say interesting in Arabic?
Interesting?
Yes.
Interesting. You can say رائعة, مدهشة. Okay? We'll come. After this, we'll come to the adjectives, my dear. Okay? Now we just focus on the words. And then we'll come to the adjectives. And also we have a new adjective today. Not only interesting. And we have other adjectives. So, المستشفى. My students, think, who goes to the hospital?
The patient. Someone goes,
the patient. Ahsan. I will tell you the word in Arabic that you may use when you are writing your sentence. The patient in Arabic is al-marid. I will write it. And I will show it to you. You can also write at the same time. Try. I will dictate you and you will try to write it. Al, alif lam. You all know alif lam now. That means the in English. So alif lam. Meem. Again, like the first word of maqha and mustashfa. Al-ma. And then ra. 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 But I have al-ma-ri. So it's ra with ya. And don't forget to leave space after ra. Don't forget to leave space after ra. Ra is one of the six letters that you need to leave space just after it. So al-ma-ri. After ra, I will put ya. I'll put ya. And last, al-marid. It's dad. It's dot. It looks like sod, but with one dot up. So I will raise my paper, and this is how to say the patient. Al-marid. Al-marid. Get it? Al-marid. Naam. Naam, Noor.
Help.
Help.
In Arabic.
help. I will tell you. Help is يساعد.
معلمة؟
نعم. نعم.
معلمة؟
نعم.
معلمة؟
نعم. نعم. شيفن.
Can you show me the patient writing?
Okay. Okay. Again.
Just L. Once.
Okay. No problem. El ma. ريد المريض المريض
يذهب الى المستشفى تلها المريض يذهب
المريض
جملة.
اوكي من يقول جملة يستعمل فيها المريض والمستشفى؟ نعم
أنا لا
نعم سنة
يا
نعم سنة نستمع نو نستمع إلى سنة please now it's the turn of سنة
المريض يذهب إلى المستشفى بينما أنا أساعد المستشفى والأخت أشاهد سينما كبيرة بينما أمي تجلس على مخها ويشرب القهوة.
أحسنت أمي تجلس على المقهى وتشرب أمي تشرب القهوة أحسنت سنة This is not only sentence This is very long paragraph Well done سنة أحسنتي Very good I'm really proud of you my dear You are all amazing You are all amazing today أحسنتم إذن To go fast now because we don't have time. We only have 15 minutes left and we still have other things to learn. I just want to recap with you the words that we learned today. السينما. 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 And I wrote down المقهى, sorry. المقهى. والمستشفى. المستشفى المستشفى نعم
علما how do you say نعم. customer
how to say
customer
customer customer we can say you want to use it with المقهى yes we can say الزبون there are so many new words here and I'm done with my papers Okay, I will try to find the space to write it. Okay, I will write it up here. الزبون. It's alif, lam, za. Za is ra with dot up. Za, and then ba, and then waw, because we say boo. الزبون. الزبون. Noon. الزبون. الزبون is the customer. الزبون. But my students, شيميكا.
Yeah.
How are you, شيميكا? كيف حالك? الزبون means the customer, but I thought you will ask about another word before moving, my students. I thought you will ask about another word that you can use when talking about المستشفى. In المستشفى, في المستشفى, in the hospital, you said المريض, the patient, but you did not say who treats the patients, who gives medicines?
The doctor.
The doctor. You need to know this in Arabic. It's الطبيب. الطبيب. I want you to learn this word, my students. It will help you to talk about المستشفى. Okay, let me find the paper here to write on it. الطبيب.
معلمة.
نعم.
How do we say nurse in Arabic?
Okay, I will write the tabib and then I will write al-mumarrida. That means nurse, okay? So let's now write al-tabib. Afwan, afwan. So I will write al-tabib first. Alif lam. Ta. Then ba. But I have b. So I have ya. I need ya after ba. Al-tabib. That's the long vowel for kasra. Al-tabib. Al-tabib. I have another ba. So this is al-tabib. Okay, I will just tell you how to write al-mumarrida, the nurse, and then you will tell me the sentence, and then Ryan will move to the other slide because there is no time left. I know, my dear, that you all want to say your sentence, but you know we have to finish the lesson before the time is over. I will just okay, hospital again is al-mustashfa. The third word on your slide, on slide number 3. Al-mustashfa. Okay, so we wrote here al-tabib. Al-tabib. The doctor. Al-tabib. Someone, some of your friends ask about the word the nurse. I will write it. Just let me find space. Okay, so it's al, alif lam, and then mim again, al-mu, I have al-mu-ma, al-mu-ma means two mim, I will write al-mu-ma, the difference that the first with amma, the second with fatha, but I will not put this, al-mu-ma, ri, ra, ra, al-mu-ma, ri, ba, da, da, wa ta marbuta. See, I will put ta marbuta. Listen. My students, I'll meet you all. Sorry. Sorry, because I hear some noise. Listen. This is al-mumarrida. This is al-mumarrida. We say it with ta marbuta if she's a girl, of course. Okay, so we say al-mumarrida. So for al-mustashfa today, we learned so many words. We learned al-mustashfa, the hospital, al-marid, the patient, al-mumarrida, the nurse, and al-tabib, the doctor. Okay, get it? Can we move now, my students, to the next slide? I want to do it fast, my dear. See, I'm sorry for those who want to say sentence. Write it down if we have time, because I don't know whether we'll have time or no. If we have time, we'll write. I will listen to you. Otherwise, I told you, let dad and mom take pictures for you or videos while you are doing the live session now. Okay? You write and send it to me on my mail. I will share this with the school, okay? So let's move now to slide number 4. Let's move to slide number 4 because we have a new verb and after that we have a new adjectives. So slide number 4, I have at the top two verbs already conjugated. The first one is ara, ana, ara, huwa, yara,
hiya.
Naam.
I couldn't see the slide in the fourth one.
The fourth one, you can go back, my dear, you can go back to the conversation where I uploaded the PowerPoint already there and open from there, better from the, my screen. Okay, open the whole PowerPoint there. Just find number 4, slide number 4, and you will find it. Get me?
Yeah.
Okay. I already uploaded there on the first page, the conversation room. You will find the PowerPoint, and you can follow from there. So please, my students, now I want to do it fast. No time. Don't interrupt me. Let me explain to you these new words. And then if we have time, we'll discuss. Okay? So the first verb is the verb yara. You know, it's similar to the verb yushahid. Yushahid. So you all know yushahid. Yushahid means to watch. Yara means to see. Yara means to see. For those who cannot see how we write yara, yara, it's ya, ra, and that alif maqsura, same that same as the end of maqha and mustashfa. It's like ya at the end, but without dots. Yara, to see. Let's do it fast to conjugate it with the pronouns. Ana, a. Ana, ara. Huwa, yara. Hiya, tara. Wa nahnu, nara. I think all of you know the rule now of the verb. So just the meaning of yara is a new verb. It's a new verb. Naam.
Naam. I can't mark the attendance because it's not loading the attendance for marking.
Okay. I'll
mark the attendance.
I will tell you at the end how to do it, okay? Don't worry.
Okay.
Good, Sophie. Okay. Carry on, please, now with listening to me. I said the new verb of today is yara. It has the same meaning of yushahid, and it's conjugated the same way, okay? You always follow the same rule when you are conjugating the verb with ana, huwa, hiya, nahnu. Ana, a, huwa, ya, hiya, ta, wa nahnu, na. Here I can share with you some sentence already that you can see on the PowerPoint on the slide number 4. Albint tara almustashfa. And I have another verb also on the same slide. The verb, this is an old verb, you all know it. The verb you hib. Let's conjugate it together. Ana. Ahsant. You all know yuhib. That means to love or to like. So, ana uhib. Huwa yuhib. Hiya tuhib. Nahnu nuhib. Always pay attention to this. The problem that you all know the rule, but sometimes when you say your sentence, you forget. You always use a with all the pronouns. Naam.
Naam, my when will the class finish?
Still 5 minutes or 6 minutes, okay? Shivan, please keep your mic mute. Okay, so now here, there are the verbs and the way how to use the verbs. You know this. Just you learned today the new verb, yara. So now, instead of using yushahid all the time, you can use sometimes yara. Ana ara al-maqha. Ana ara al-cinema. Ana ara al-mustashfa. Ana ara al-tabib. Ana ara al-marid. So many sentences. Shivan, please keep your mic mute, Shivan. Shukran, Shivan. So now, fast, we will move to slide number 5. We'll move to slide number 5. This is very important, and this is the last part of today because I have two new adjectives. عندي صفتان جديدتان. صفة, صفة, adjective. You know so many adjectives. Remember the last week we talked about كبير, صغير, جميل, رائع, مدهش, جديد, new, نظيف, clean. So many. You know so many. You know طويل. Today we are going... نظيفة أحسنتي نظيفة. And I told you, you are تمربوطة when it is feminine, حسنتي. Today, I will tell you about two new adjectives, and there is a rule. It's not a rule, but it's an exception of the rule. I want you all to listen to me, please. This is very important. Just listen to me for the last few minutes. So, I have the adjective, and I'll explain it to you here. قريب. قريب. See, I will draw, for example, المدرسة. And just next to it, I have, for example, المقهى. Okay? So, if you see the distance between المدرسة and المقهى, it's too close. When two things are close to each other, we say قريب. قريب. It's about the distance, okay? قريب. Close. For example, I'll give you a sentence. البنت تذهب إلى المستشفى القريبة. القريبة. ما معنى قريب؟ Close. Okay? Very near. It's near. Now think about the opposite of close. Think about the opposite of near. Something it's, that says very far. Something that is far. For far, we say بعيد. بعيد. For example, I'll draw it again here, المدرسة. But I have a cinema very far. So here, as you see, the distance here is different from the distance here. If it is close, we say قريب. If it is far, we say بعيد. بعيد. And you can look at the sentence that you have on the slide. The first one we said, البنت تذهب إلى المستشفى القريبة. The girl goes to the close or near hospital. And نحن, the second sentence, نحن نحب المقهى البعيد. We like the cafe that is far away. Get it? I just want to tell you an exception, not to be confused, my students. When you are sometimes, if you will open this slide in your own, you may get confused. Why? I told you before that we use ta marbuta for the adjective when the noun ends with ta marbuta. Get me? So this is the rule. You have a noun that takes ta marbuta at the end. I put an adjective that takes ta marbuta at the end. But if you look here at the same sentence, البنت تذهب إلى المستشفى القريبة. For قريبة, for the adjective, I put ta marbuta. But if I look at the noun, المستشفى, there is no ta marbuta. So in Arabic, there is a rule, okay? But still there are some irregular nouns or some exceptions that they don't take ta marbuta, but they are feminine. Like المستشفى, okay? Mainly, places with that long vowel. At the end, here I have المستشفى. I have a cinema. A cinema also, it takes alif at the end. It doesn't take ta marbuta, but it's a feminine word. So when I want to add an adjective to the word مستشفى or to the word cinema, please keep that in mind. I have to add ta marbuta to the adjective, even there is no ta marbuta to these two words. Get me? And remember as well when I told you that for all the cities, and for all the countries, for all the words of cities and countries, they don't have ta marbuta, but they are feminine. And feminine in Arabic, remember the word, مؤنث. So إذا كانت الكلمة مؤنث فالصفة مؤنث. If the word is feminine, the adjective is feminine. Normally, we know feminine with تاء مربوطة, but for few exceptions, the word is feminine even there is no تاء مربوطة, like Dubai, it's a place, like Abu Dhabi, it's a city. I mean, the cities are all feminine, even they have تاء مربوطة or no. And today we learned المستشفى, a cinema. They don't have تاء مربوطة at the end, but they are feminine. So I say المستشفى الكبيرة, السينما الكبير. But don't worry, even if you don't put تاء مربوطة, we'll consider it as correct, because these are, I mean, few exceptions that only few people can know about it. Get me, my dear? This is the whole lesson of today. Let's see what we learned. We learned السينما, المقهى, والمستشفى. These are the new places. And we learn a new verb. Yara. I hope that you are all listening to me. Yara. And we learned the two new adjectives. قريب, بعيد, far. قريب, close. بعيد, far.
معلمة؟
نعم.
What is قريب?
قريب means close. It's not far. It's the opposite of far. It's close. Get me?
Okay, yes, thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome. Afwan. Now it's time. I don't want you to miss. Maybe you have other sessions. I don't want you to miss your sessions and your other studies. This is the lesson of today. If you want to send me your work, your videos, your pictures, please send it on the mail. Till next week, inshallah. We'll start doing the assignments. Next week, we'll start doing the assignments. And I sent to you an example about assignments and some quizzes on the team. Bye. Ma'a salama.
Bye.
Ma'a salama. Don't forget to mark your attendance. Yes, na'am. There is someone who is calling me. Na'am.
Should we mark the attendance?
To mark the attendance. Yeah, Sophie, yes.
Ma'a salama.
Thank you. I will just explain. Ma'a salama. Ma'a salama. Let me explain to your friends how to mark the attendance. You go to the first page, the conversation page, the chat page. After posts, I hope you can see the word post, files, etc. Wait, please. And then you will find whether the word more, you click on it and you will find, I mean, in the form of attendance that you have to do, or you'll find the 3 points there. Try to check, I mean, to press on it, or plus, try to find there. Okay. But if it is not there, I will try to mark it. Yes? Naam.
Should we hang up?
Yes, please. We are done now. I will not leave till you all leave now. Ma'a salama. See you next week. Ma'a salama. Naam.
I already marked the attendance.
Very good. Very good. I'm talking to those who cannot do it. Okay?
So.
Ma'a salama. Ma'a salama. Ma'a salama. Shukran. Please leave the conversation now. Hang out. Okay? Shukran.